Pip Carapeline steerman. Go 5 for us just a couple minutes. That's Marcus Payne at the controls, steerman. And in the background, we have three of our T6s from the Geico Skytypers team. And behind the steerman, we have Mr. Matt Chapman, his Cap 580, a Thunderbolt 580 aircraft. Yes, all these planes will fly sometime this afternoon. Mother Nature mind, looks like she's being real nice to us right now. We got blue skies, unlimited visibility, ceilings way the heck up there. They gave 17,000 foot ceiling. That's our C-17 departs the airport. You will be, because that ramp's almost a mile long from end to end. If you see a piece of paper on the ground, no big deal. Bend over, pick up, deposit one of the many garbage cans out there. They're yellow. They're easy to spot. Throw it in one of the garbage cans and makes the clinic guys and gals' job a whole lot easier this afternoon. And for you all go home, we got to clean this place up because you left papers on the ground. So no big deal. Bend over, pick up, deposit one of the garbage cans, please. We appreciate that. Keep saying there is no smoking on the ramp except the designated smoking areas. No smoking around any of the airplanes or the food court fence. We don't want to start a fire. That sun's coming up. Most of these airplanes have been filled with fuel. The fuel's going to expand the tanks, and it may leak out the vents on the aircraft. So you do not want to start a fire because we're going to be real upset with you. That's our KC-135 taking off right now. Climbing out. Right now, the KC-10. Refueling aircraft taking on for set. They will be back in the program to a couple flybys for us, so you get to see them up close and personal. Put the sunblock on. Don't get yourself all burnt out here on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. Aircraft commander from Memphis, Tennessee. We have Captain Adam Boyd. Aircraft commander from Manhattan, Kansas. Captain Travis Cook. Safety driver, Doylestown, PA. And Tech Sergeant Jerome Thomas. Loadmaster, Chester, PA. C-17 is built to transport outsized cargo. Which can weigh in excess of 170,000 pounds. Fully loaded max weight, the aircraft weighs 585,000 pounds compared to 245,000 pounds of fuel. Next in line, the KC-135. Our posse at Lieutenant Colonel Ty from the 141st Aircraft Commander of Barnegat, New Jersey. Lieutenant Colonel Mark Strickland, the aircraft commander from Barnegat, New Jersey. We have Captain Ben Chammy, the co-pilot from Hamilton, New Jersey. And we have Master Sergeant Jose Rodriguez, the boom operator from Perth Amboy, New Jersey. Our KC-10 is Captain Nick Barber, Formation Mission Commander from Bristow, Oklahoma. Captain James Strong, Aircraft Commander from Long Island, New York. And Staff Sergeant Sean Killen, the Flight Engineer from Lakewood, Colorado. And Master Sergeant Mark Barnett, In-Flight Refueling Boom Operator from Vallejo, California.
Take a stand when liberty's
C-17 Globemaster III is the newest, most flexible cargo aircraft to enter the airlift force. The C-17 is capable of a rapid strategic delivery of troops and all types of cargo to main operating bases or directly to forward bases in the deployment area. The aircraft is also capable of performing tactical airlift and airdrop missions when required. The inherent flexibility and performance of the C-17 force improve the ability of the total airlift system to fulfill the worldwide air mobility requirements of the United States. The KC-10AX centers an air mobility command advanced tanker and cargo aircraft designed to provide increased global mobility for U.S. and armed forces. Although the KC-10A's primary mission is air refueling, it can combine the tasks of tanker and cargo aircraft by refueling fighters and simultaneously carrying the fighter support personnel and equipment to overseas deployments. The KC-10A can operate or transport up to 75 people and nearly 170,000 pounds of cargo, a distance of about 404,400 miles, unrefueled. KC-135 Stratotanker's principal mission is air refueling. This unique asset greatly enhances the United States Air Force capability to accomplish its primary missions of global reach and global power. It also provides air refueling to support to Air Force, Navy, and Marine Corps aircraft, as well as aircraft of all allied nations. KC-10 or KC-135 or C-17 is going to stay up there because they're going to demonstrate an aerial drop for us in a little bit of a while. We can recover the two airplanes. While they're doing that, it's a good time to wander back, grab yourself something to eat, something to drink, stay hydrated this afternoon. We do not want anybody passing out because of the heat this afternoon or not drinking enough. Keep yourselves hydrated. We want all the medical personnel to be able to sit back and enjoy the show this afternoon just as you will. Again, if you're walking around looking at the airplanes on static display, be careful around some of the airplanes. They are fabric covered. Most of them are metal. Well, some are covered in fabric, and you could poke a hole through the side of the airplane. You could scratch the paint. We don't want you to do that either, because you scratch the paint on some guy's airplane, he's going to be a little upset with you, trust me. Again, no smoking on the ramp anywhere this afternoon. There are designated smoking areas. If you feel the need to light up, find that smoking area so you can go back and light up illegally.
my sister and me to the
road. If you see someone smoking in my designated area, ask them to put the cigarette in and we'll wander back to a designated area. We'll put it out first, then wander back.
Attack, a mighty sucker punch came flying in from somewhere in the back. Soon as